infantrymen are vulnerable to different weapons, including gunfire. Till now, there's no way for a military to protect its infantry soldiers from a 50 caliber machine gun. But this could be about to change. The Russian military equipment manufacturer Rostec has stated that it's developing a body armor named Sotnik, or Centurion, that will be able to stop the bullet from a 50 caliber machine gun. This has the potential to change the way an infantryman approaches a battleground. As per task and purpose, Russia's ground forces plans to distribute this armor to its soldiers sometime in 2025. Sotnik is expected to augment and ultimately replace the current Ratnik equipment set. Viewers may note that the currently used Ratnik package includes everything from body armor to the flashlight, as well as different carrying gears. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russian Sotnik could be the most impressive body armor ever made. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The Ratnik suit is one of the most well-designed ones. The Ratnik suit, which consists of 10 subsystems and 59 individual components, includes modernized body armor designed to withstand 7.62 millimeter rounds, a helmet with a special eye monitor outfitted with a thermal night vision monocular and flashlight, and integrated communication systems. According to Army Technology, it also features a self-contained heater, a backpack, an individual water filter, a gas mask, and a medical kit. As per Rostec, by the end of 2020, it had delivered more than 300,000 second-generation Ratnik combat gear outfits. Sotnik will be a major upgrade over Ratnik and has some ambitious goals, to say the least. According to Rostec's Bekan Ozdoev, the new generation gear will consist of a fundamentally new set of technology, including the latest achievements of the Russian defense industry, including robotic equipment and integrated systems for exchanging information. It's stated that the first stage of development, the definition of tactical and technical requirements, have already been started. As per some reports, several elements of third-generation Sotnik armor is already undergoing preliminary tests. But the most eye-popping claim is the one regarding the protection level on the fourth-generation one. Ozdoev has stated the fourth-generation Sotnik armor will consist of lightweight polyethylene fiber and armor plating that's engineered to withstand a direct shot from a 50-caliber M2 Browning. He added, "The gear will not restrict movement and will allow you to take the extra weight necessary to perform special missions." Polyethylene is a lightweight, durable thermoplastic with a variable crystalline structure. It's one of the most widely produced plastics in the world. Actually, tens of millions of tons are produced worldwide each year, and is used in a variety of applications ranging from plastic parts, tubes, etc. Many kinds of polyethylene, or PE, are known, with most having the chemical formula C2H4N. PE is usually a mixture of similar polymers of ethylene with various values of N. It can be low density or high density. One property of polyethylene is that it melts, and this has been used to develop polyethylene armor. This is how it actually works. As a hot bullet impacts the armor, it melts the polyethylene. This causes the molten polyethylene to stick to the bullet and slows it down. If the polyethylene layer is thick enough, it will be able to stop a bullet. The challenge is to make the layer thin enough so that a suit can be contoured out from it and a soldier can actually wear it. Also, it will, in some way, have to be reinforced by hard materials like steel or titanium. The weight aspect has to be taken care of. A very heavy armor will restrict mobility and easily tire an infantryman. Russia has already developed a polyethylene armor named Super Thread. Russian media has claimed that it's lighter than Israeli and American body armors, but offers better protection. Current US Level 3 body armor will stop a 150 grain, 7.62 mm, 308 Winchester bullet, imparting 1,878 foot-pounds of energy on the target. The US Army's modular, scalable vest is capable of stopping 7.62 mm rounds, but weighs a total of 10.25 kilograms or 22.6 pounds. 50 caliber bullets takes firepower to the next level and presents a strong challenge. Many videos on YouTube are available which depicts its destructive power. Viewers can check them out to understand the enormity of the task. A 50 caliber bullet is massive. It weighs more than 4 times and imparts 11,070 foot-pounds of energy on a target, which is almost 6 times that of 7.62 mm round. A bullet like this can be stopped by 1¼ inch of AR-500 grade steel. So obviously an armor made primarily with steel will be too heavy. While nowadays air power is the key to winning a battle, there is still no 100% substitute for having boots on the ground. The infantry will remain the backbone of an army. It's equally important in peacetime and combat. There's no replacement of infantry in foreseeable future. So it's natural that advanced nations are pouring in resources to provide their infantry soldiers the best they can have. Russia has been one of the flag bearers when it comes to armor. It's hard to imagine the amount of plastic that would be required to stop a 50 caliber bullet. With current technology and armor designed to stop rounds 4 to 5 times heavier and more powerful than 7.62 mm would be too heavy and cumbersome for an infantry soldier. A groundbreaking solution will be needed to surmount this challenge. It remains to be seen how Rostec and the Russian military industry at large are able to take on this seemingly impossible task. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.